dignitaries on the dais and dignitaries off the dais. A very warm welcome this afternoon. I'm sure the initiative taken by the first speaker is a bigger challenge to keep you all awake now for the next sessions after lunch. What I'm going to share with you is some research done over a period of time with my experience of using technology into the classroom and moving towards classroom, digital classrooms. Just give me a minute and I'll just start my presentation. Keeping in mind the topic for today, technology challenges and digital insights. What really research shows, what are the kind of children that we are looking in the coming 21st century skills that they need to develop? The students of the future should be able to solve problems, think creatively, think critically, able to challenge, debate, discuss, make decisions. I think that's the most critical part of our education. Analyze and evaluate information and ideas and plan for the future. There's another research by universities in the US talking about what employers are looking forward to. They're looking that the future generation needs to be good communicators, have good planning and organization skills, teamwork, problem solving, self-management, initiatives and enterprise, and finally, use of technology. We can't predict the future of these students, but we can provide the technologies that will shape it for themselves. To start with, can anybody tell me what is this child doing in the picture? Anybody in the audience? He's watching this book. He's asking a question. He's pointing out to a picture and asking a question. What did he do now?
He's not interested.
He's not interested?
No.
Okay. He's looking at the watch. He's seen the picture of the watch in the book and he's able to identify with the watch that the teacher is wearing in her hand. Now the teacher actually shows him that you can listen to some sound of the watch and see what the child does. He actually puts his head down and tries to listen to the magazine. This is the 21st century learner. These are the challenges that we face. So to equip the 21st century learners with the required skills, research shows, and we have actually gone through a lot of research at Podar International School, how can you integrate technology into the curriculum? I think that's the biggest challenge that schools have. How do you make sure that you maintain a balance of technology and the curriculum? So I just go back to how at Podar we moved on to digital classrooms. To start with, we started with blackboards. There you will see me using overhead projectors. I'm sure you all know what OHP was, where we to actually write transparencies and teach through transparencies. Then we moved on from transparencies to TV and computers in class. After that, we moved on to flat screen computers. After that, we moved on to interactive boards. Then to laptops, and now we have iPads in school. I don't know how many of you know we were in the Times of India yesterday, all over the country. People are talking about school forcing students to buy iPads because I feel strongly that's the future of this country. I'll just go to the next slide. What is it that we did? How did we go about the entire process of moving from blackboard to interactive board to laptops and then going to iPads? Most important thing is, of course, professional development, training teachers on how to use technology. Second challenge is modifying the syllabus, modifying the curriculum on how to integrate technology into the curriculum. make sure that the timetable of the school is modified, changed, to show how you can actually introduce technology into the classroom. Most important, educate parents. Make parents aware of how technology helps their children. Invest in various softwares that are required to use in classroom relating to the curriculum. And also make sure there is lesson plans integrated with curriculum. What are the different softwares that we use? There's a whole list of softwares. Some of them, most important one is what we used was Cyber 3D Science, which is a very good software that we use at Pudar. Another important software is Rubicon Atlas, that's on cloud computing. And everything is basically, the entire curriculum is planned on Rubicon Atlas. That's another very important aspect of our process. What are the insights of the digital technology? What was the impact it made on teachers? Teachers became more confident and motivated, increased dedication to the school support, increased cooperative and collaborative working among staff. A bank of digital lesson plans can be shared among teachers of various subjects. Interaction with peers, interaction with students. A lot of ICT skills developed over a period of time. And of course, it allows the teachers to have immediate feedback after analyzing the students' performances. What was the impact on the students? Make learning more meaningful and enjoyable? Definitely, like the previous speaker said, enhances student learning and improves understanding of difficult concepts. World of knowledge is opened up for students at a click of a mouse. We all know that with internet, you can actually access any information just with a click of mouse. Effective in promoting teamwork and collaborative learning among students, brings about creativity, gives them ideas, encourages them to discuss and research further. We all feel that the attendance in the classroom increase, especially when we talk about our grade 11th and 12th, that more students coming into class when we had introduced laptops in the class and now, of course, iPads. Boost the confidence and morale of students. Students' assignments evaluate on teamwork, leadership qualities, and organization skills. Research skills are enhanced. Inspire students to achieve academic excellence. And of course, they are prepared for 21st century skills, problem solving, critical thinking, and collaboration. Yes, finally, I'd like to end with a small research that we did. I must tell you, there was this that we tried two various classrooms. Just to cut it short, in a classroom we provided iPads and we had a session in another classroom without any technology, and we found that the results of this class was better than that class. So that's what this small research that we'd like to share. Thank you.